This new Star Wars trailer is the most exciting I've seen in almost a decade. The Acolyte's new trailer is easily the most exciting one from Star Wars in almost a decade. A prequel to the prequels, the Acolyte is set at the tail end of the High Republic era, the golden age of the Jedi Order. This was a time when the light of the Jedi shone brightly across the galaxy, but the Sith flourished in the shadows preparing for their revenge. The Acolyte's first two episodes will premiere on Disney Plus on June 4th, meaning marketing has picked up. While it's true Lucasfilm's marketing for their last Disney Plus live-action show, Ahsoka, was disrupted by the strikes, there's never been anything quite like this before. The internet is abuzz with interviews and every day seems to bring a new clip or trailer, still somehow mysterious, still concealing as much as they reveal. But the latest Acolyte trailer is easily the best I've seen from Lucasfilm in almost a decade. First, some context. I'm not exactly new to Star Wars. I've loved the franchise since 1991 when I watched the first movie and picked up Timothy Zahn's Heir to the Empire. I remember seeing the first trailer for Star Wars, Episode 1, The Phantom Menace, and I even more clearly recall tearing up when I heard Han say "Chewie, we're home" in the trailer for Star Wars, The Force Awakens. Star Wars has had some great trailers, but I don't think it will ever be possible for one to tug on my heartstrings more than that one. But this comes close. The best trailers tell a story, and Star Wars Evolve trailer pulls this off so very well. It feels as much like a horror movie as anything else, opening with ragged, desperate, breathing dialogue discussing a Jedi killer and a shadowy Sith Lord unmasked. This time the trailer promises Star Wars is exploring the dark side of the Force. The characters of the Acolyte will be faced with the Sith discovering their true nature at last. Even the little text tells a story. Before the Menace, the trailer tells us, and that's all we really need to know to plunge into this new era. This is before the Phantom Menace, the prequel to the prequels, inspired by aspects of that story and recontextualizing them in tried and true Star Wars fashion. Notice it's not before the Phantom Menace, which rather amuses me. It seems to imply that all Baneite Sith are phantoms, but Palpatine is the Menace, a neat way of underscoring his importance and promising this won't undermine the canon. The upcoming Star Wars show The Acolyte will take the franchise into the Grand High Republic era, but what mysteries await in the Jedi's Golden Age? It helps, of course, that I couldn't be much more invested in The Acolyte. As much as I love Star Wars, the franchise has a habit of overplaying the nostalgia card. It's been there from the start when the Bantam era books recycled lines of dialogue from the movies with a knowing wink to readers, and it's become even more noticeable in the Disney era. But The Acolyte is something fresh and new, inspired by the reflections of lifelong fan Leslie Headland dipping its toe in the waters of a time period we've never seen on screen before. The fight choreography is stunning, with the trailers and clips so far focusing on breathtaking martial arts and stunt work. There's a reason the athletic Daphne Keane, who was phenomenal as X-23 in Logan, is part of this. Even more exciting though is the sense of mystery surrounding The Acolyte. Leslie Headland is renowned for a tricky writing style where every episode features a surprising twist, and I can't wait to see that approach brought to life in the Star Wars galaxy. What's great though is that The Acolyte's marketing is hiding so much. Yes, there have been leaks, unfortunate ones that I kind of wish I hadn't seen. But those feel like episode 1 leaks rather than final twists, meaning there are still so many unknowns. Meanwhile, the Acolyte trailers are deliberately concealing far more of the story than they reveal, focusing on stunning action and beautiful cinematography rather than spilling the major details. That above trailer is the perfect example, but there's one detail that really stands out. We don't know much about the Acolyte's mysterious Sith Lord. Is it Palpatine's mentor Darth Plagueis? Is it Darth Tenebris, the legend Sith master of Plagueis, who's been name-dropped in canon a couple of times? Or is something else going on? Whatever the truth may be, that trailer shows his helmet discarded and it feels like a promise. Now the mask of the Sith will be cast away and their true face will be seen. Personally, I couldn't be more excited, especially after this trailer. The Acolyte is a television series set in the Star Wars universe at the end of the High Republic era, where both the Jedi and the Galactic Empire were at the height of their influence. This sci-fi thriller sees a former Padawan reunite with her former Jedi Master as they investigate several crimes, all leading to darkness erupting from beneath the surface and preparing to bring about the end of the High Republic. We want to hear from you. Share your opinions in the thread below and remember to keep it respectful. A stunning new trailer for The Acolyte promises to unmask the Sith Lord of the High Republic era, setting up Jedi deaths and some incredible action. The co-showrunners of the ABC crime procedural Will Trent discuss whether they might bring on a major character from the books in Season 3. The CSI Vegas series finale was one of the spin-off's best hours, highlighting why the show didn't deserve to be cancelled after three seasons. Although the sitcom spin-off may have tried to replace Roseanne Barr's Roseanne the Conner's Season 6 finale admitted that this plan didn't work out. Doctor Who Season 14 is evolving the show while still honoring what came before it with callbacks to a forgotten aspect of the Doctor's character. New photos from the set of Netflix's Stranger Things Season 5 have emerged online, confirming a return to a major location featured in Season 4. Now that the CW has cancelled one of their biggest shows, Jared Padalecki's Walker, there is room for Supernatural Season 16 to fill in that gap.